This is an elevated pressure vessel, called column. Piping designers make the design this way, and they also design pipe supports. However, the finalization of the design for determining the loads on the nozzle and the supports are left to piping stress engineers. Let's take a look at the supports designed by the pipe designer. Piping stress engineers must ensure the protection of the pipe, the shell of the vessel, and nozzles. To achieve this, they can make certain modifications both in the design and location of supports, as well as in the piping design. In this example, the pipe is supported both from above and below. However, as previously mentioned, due to this design, the lower layer of support and the upper nozzle will interact with each other, and thus, the upper support will not bear any load. As a result, a moment will be generated on the upper nozzle due to thermal expansion, and the lower layer of support will have to bear an additional load, leading to stresses on the pipe. To prevent this, loads applied to the nozzle are minimized by designing an expansion loop that is close to the upper nozzle and circulates around the pressure vessel. In this case, the pipe is supported from the upper elevation using a rigid support. By adding a stopper to this support, similar expansions are ensured for the pipe and equipment at the operating temperature. In the downward continuation of the pipe, the supports welded onto the pressurized vessel are utilized as guide only, to direct the thermal expansion of the pipe downward. After the pipe transitions to a horizontal position, the weight of the pipe is carried over the pipe rack with rigid supports. As a result, as mentioned earlier, both the pipe, the vessel, and the nozzle are protected from overstresses. In this example, spring supports can also be used if the operation temperature is high. We will discuss examples related to spring supports on columns in subsequent videos. If you liked the video, please subscribe and hit the like button for more videos.